I'm gonna just sit here for that.
Okay.
Then I'll come in the other way. Get up and make an announcement. Okay. But you don't want any, she keeps poking you to keep you awake.
Sing happy birthday to Pastor John.
Yes.
welcome to worship this morning. There will be a celebration of life service for Bonnie Crandall here at the church tomorrow at 11 a.m. with a visitation beforehand starting at 9:30. So services for Bonnie Crandall, 11 a.m. here at the church tomorrow with a visitation starting at 9:30. Are there other things that we ought to be announcing this morning? You said yeah? Oh. Anybody else? Oh, good, because we have some young people waiting to come in. I invite you to please rise as you are able. Trusting in the word of life given in baptism, we are gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our gathering hymn this morning is hymn number 581, You Are Mine. After the first verse, if you're a hymnal user, we will go to the refrain rather than to the second verse. Those of you using the screens, don't worry, sing what's on the screen.
You will hear my voice, I thank you as my joy.
committee, the task force, or whatever we're calling that group, was very excited at it. Because 24 people had reactivated or joined our congregation. And they said, Pastor, you don't look very excited about that. And I kind of, you know, snottily said when they questioned me about how, what level of new member having we would have to have in order for me to be satisfied and happy. I said, well, when we start baptizing adults, I will be satisfied that we're growing a church. And pretty shortly after that, this young lady here shows up at church with her grandparents and says, this has never happened before in my career. I know I'm confirmation age. I want to do confirmation. I know I'm late. I demand to be allowed in confirmation classes. And I will do whatever is necessary in order to make confirmation happen on time for me. And so this binder is the product of the work that she has done and completed in order to make her confirmation happen on time. So don't think that I let her out of any of the work. In fact, this is probably more work, and it's all very high quality. And if anybody wants to see it, it's right here. Then, a couple weeks ago, we said, you know, I never really got properly baptized. And I said, oh no, the Holy Spirit is starting to send us what is considered an adult baptism. So this here is considered an adult baptism today, and it is the Holy Spirit's answer to your pastor about whether this church is growing or not. The answer is yes. Even by the strictest standards today, we have a sign that our church is growing. And that's a wonderful, wonderful thing. Did you know that about your story? Now she knows. All right. Sorry about that. I stopped and told the story. Mr. Burritz, you have a line.
Why a line?
I believe so. Someone has a line. Oh, I have a line. I was so excited to tell my story. God, you're right, it's me. In the sacrament of baptism, God promises to forgive our sins by grace alone, to adopt us into the body of Christ the Church, to send the Holy Spirit daily to renew and cleanse us, and to resurrect us to eternal life. That promise of forgiveness and new life is made visible in the water of baptism. This water cleanses, purifies, refreshes, sustains, and Jesus Christ is living water. By water and the Word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Christ. Sponsors?
We present Scarlett Rose Smith for baptism.
Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in grace and love of God, do you desire to have Scarlett be baptized?
We do.
As you bring Scarlett to receive the gift of baptism, we entrust you with certain responsibilities, although for like 20 minutes. To live with her among God's faithful people, to bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, to place in her hands the Holy Scripture, and nurture her in faith and prayer, so that she may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, and care for others and the world God made. Do you promise to help Scarlett grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
Do you promise to nurture Scarlett in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
People of God, do you promise to support Scarlett and to pray for her in her new life in Christ? If so, please say, we do.
We do. Okay.
It is time to put the water in the pot. Thank you. waters of the earth. You are the fire of rebirth. You poured out your spirit on your people Israel. You breathed fire of life into dry bones. Your son Jesus promised to send spirit to us so that the world can know your peace and truth. Pour out your Holy Spirit and breathe new life into Scarlet, who is here baptized. By your spirit, adopt us all as your children. Through our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Scarlet Rose Smith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and son new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Scarlet Rose with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Scarlet Rose Smith, check you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Let us welcome the newly baptized Scarlet Rose Smith.
We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's created and redeeming word to all the world.
Oh, yeah.
I invite you to please rise as you are able.
Oh, the peace in the world will not be available.
love one another, to follow in the way of his commandments, and to share his risen life with all the world. For he lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
I invite you to please be seated.
First reading is Acts 7, 55 to 60. Filled with the Holy Spirit, Stephen gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. Look, he said, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. But they covered their ears, and with a loud shout, all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning him, he prayed, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Then he knelt down and cried out in a loud voice, Lord, do not hold this sin against them. When he had said this, he died. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalms 31. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge? Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me into your righteousness.
Incline your ear to me and make haste to deliver me.
Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe, for you are my craig and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me.
Take me out of the net that they have secretly set for me, for you are my tower of strength.
Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O Lord, God of truth.
My time has been in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies, and from those who persecute me.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me into your steadfast love. Second meaning is Peter, the first. Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, so that by it may grow into salvation. If indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good, come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight, and like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices, acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, see, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you, then, who believe, he is precious, but to those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobeyed the word, as they were destined to do, but you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. The word of God, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We stand for God's blessing.
From now on, you do not know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Christ. Please be seated. I invite the one forward at this time to share her faith statement with us.
Hi, my name is Mom Hansel. I'm 14 years old. I am the daughter of Henry and Julie and Josh Hansel. My baptismal sponsors are Kristen Clements and Chris Barker. In my free time, I like to practice and play sports. Some of the sports that I play are softball, volleyball, basketball, and track. I've been on track from 6th grade up to 8th grade. This year, probably in my last year. But hopefully I'll continue to do that throughout high school and throughout college. I have been in Sunday school since I'm the age of 4, and I did it last year too. The Bible verse that I've chosen to write about can be used in sports and it's a real motivation booster and can also help boost your confidence if needed. The verse is from Luke chapter 21, verse 19. Stand firm and you will live life. This quote I found online, and she hadn't really talked that much about many Bible quotes in confirmation because we spend most of our time doing like specific lessons that pastors planned out. And this quote stood out to me and it made me think that if I would have quit and never tried to get any better at the sports I play, where I would be today, and do I really? Because I don't have a lot of free time, because I practice sports a lot, and I work. So, yeah. That's my life.
My name is Scarlett Rose Smith. I am 14 years old, and I am the daughter of Thomas Smith and Tara Nelson. My grandparents are James and William Keith. My baptism sponsors are my Aunt Ashley and my Uncle Tim. In my free time, I enjoy reading, sports, and being with our dogs. I enjoy learning more about the Bible during Bible study. Bible study helps me understand the message of God is sending and how I can use that message in my life. Sports help clear my mind and keeps me strong physically and mentally. I love being with our dogs as well. Who doesn't love being with their dogs? I have many role models I look up to that I will just mention with you. I will start with my dad, who takes care of our family and talks to me about how family is the key. Protecting each other and looking out for each other. Being good and kind to everyone, even if they aren't to you. That can be hard sometimes. My dad shows me how saying you have to trust God and he knows what he's doing. My aunt Ashley taught me how to stay calm and think of what is happening around me. She wants me to think of what other people are doing and going through, what I can do and how I can help them. She shows me how to be a good person every day, shows me unconditionally just like God. My grandpa has taught me through leading by example when times are difficult. We went to the hospital when COVID-19 was coming and no one knew what would happen. He got everything ready as he could before it came to our town, with a lot of other people helping him. He showed me how to stay strong through it while helping others. He told us God would take care of us. My grandma has taught me so many life lessons. She has been the one to get me to basketball, dance, musicals, etc. She has taught me how to live my life. She has helped me through hard times and how to get through them. She helps me understand God's message and helps me apply it to my daily life. She always keeps me on track so I do not fall off my path. She has taught me so much. She is a cancer survivor and she says she owes that to her faith in God. I would like to say that I have seen God at work in lives of my role models. And through them, he is teaching me. I am also learning from Pastor Jordan Bible Study and through her messages to us at the church. This is all God's work. The Bible verse I picked was Proverbs 3:5, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. What does this verse mean to me? It means more than just one thing. It means to trust the Lord and let him do what he does best, lead you down your path. It means not to second guess the Lord, for he knows what is to come and you do not. The Lord will never do something to hurt you. He leads you. Everything that the Lord does is for a reason that we cannot fully understand unless we trust him with our whole heart and go down the path he wants us to. The second part is to lean not on your own understanding. To me, this means not to go based off what we know, but because you do not know the full picture. Only God does. I chose this because sometimes we do not trust the Lord with our whole heart and we think we know better. I think trusting him with our whole heart is one of the most important things you can do in your relationship with God. For me, this is a meaning of faith.
I invite you to join with me in singing the hymn of the day. Renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God. The powers of this world rebel against
that rebel against God, and the ways of sin that draw you from God. If so, please say, I renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Yolanda Scarlett, you have made public affirmation of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant that God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? If so, please say, I do, and I ask God to help and guide me. People of God, do you promise to support these sisters and pray for them in their life in Christ?
We do, and we ask God to help and guide us.
I invite the baptismal sponsors and parents, and anyone that these young people have invited forward and laying on a hands forward at this time. Water and the Holy Spirit, you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us to eternal life. Stir up in Yvonne and Scarlett the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Stir up in your bond and start with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and light, the spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen.
Let us rejoice with these sisters in Christ.
We rejoice with you in the light of baptism.
Together we will give thanks and praise to God,
and proclaim the good news to all the world.
Sick and in need of comfort, We pray for Jack Pelton, for R.J. Rogers, for the family and friends of Bonnie Crandall, for the family and friends of Russell Dillon, for the family and friends of Ron Engvall, Hannah Turdo, Stephen Potter, David Delahue, Dwayne Weisenhaus, Elwood Severson, Lawrence Olson, Randy Muhlenberg, Ken Plants, Donna Christensen, Dennis Stark, Bill Holtz, and all those who suffer because of war or disaster. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Assuring God, you accompany your people amid uncertainty and change. Uphold people in this community who have recently moved, changed jobs or schools, retired, or are going through transitions of any kind. Lead us in your ways. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
I invite you to share a sign of peace with God and with one another.
Thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ,
who on this day overcame death in the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth, and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy,
shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
You may be seated. Here at this congregation, we believe that the gifts of God are meant for all of God's people. And so if you are among us, and you are a part of God's people, even if you are not a member of this congregation, you are welcome to participate in communion at our church if you so desire. Come and taste and see.
Take away the sin.
Let us pray. Gracious God, in you we live and move and have our being. With your word and this meal of grace, you've nourished our life together. Strengthen us to show your love and serve the world in Jesus' name. Amen. Our closing hymn this morning is hymn number 595, Jesus Loves Me. Spirit to live in the new creation. Amen.